So in this webinar po, our guest speaker will be discussing cloud computing and DevOps.
Now, we are very excited to introduce our esteemed guest speaker for today. Ms. Atacha is a computer science graduate, a magna cum laude, a content creator, seasoned public speaker and mentor, former application analyst, technical community manager, and social media specialist. She is currently the sustaining engineer and KCS coach at Partech Incorporated, with over 100 speaking engagements since 2020. She shares her knowledge with various universities and tech companies about the fundamentals of web development, web design, information security, database systems, and automation. She is an advocate for social participation and has been engaging with tech communities to share her knowledge and experiences in the tech industry. Atacha aspires to be a computer science professor and cybersecurity analyst.
Please join us in welcoming Ms. Athena Aliafe Abe. Feel free to use the chat to send your applause and reactions.
Hello. Ayan. Okay. I'm not sure if people are able to use the chat, since I think the Zoom meeting that was set up is in a webinar format. But if it's okay with the organizers, they can also, if they can unmute their mics then. Kasi I'm not sure if they can chat. I can only see hosts and panelists. But yeah, thank you for that wonderful introduction, Victoria and Rybert. So I'll start by sharing my screen. And I do see your reactions though. May nagka-applause, may nagka-heart. Ayan, thank you. All right. Sharing my screen. Hopefully, I would be able to see you guys engage. Most likely, may hiya kayong mag-unmute. So that's why hopefully there's a way for us to access the chat. Or I think we can have a workaround of utilizing the Q&A. Let's see, can you guys try to chat in the question and answer section instead? Because I believe hindi na siguro natin mamomodify ang webinar chat. Ayan. I have the question and answer portion open. Kahit mag-type lang kayo ng hi or hello. So we can use that. Thank you. Ayan. Ito na lang yung gamitin nating chat. Ayan. Hello. Ayan. Okay lang na may anonymous attendee. Hello. Okay. Very good. So we'll just use the Q&A as a workaround. Ayan, meron na host and panelists lang yung pwede sa webinar chat. Pero for the others, let's just use the Q&A. Okay, very good. I have, nasa isang buong monitor ko yung Q&A. Okay, so as what was already introduced, we will be talking about cloud computing and DevOps. Ayan. I've already been introduced. My name is Athena. You can call me Acha. Kanina na pagsasabay yung Athena and Acha, but I mostly can call me Acha. Ayan. And I'm currently working for a restaurant technology company that is based in New York, but I live here in California as a sustaining engineer and knowledge-centered service coach. So I have been in the tech industry for 3 years. I started working during my third year computer science student. I started as a social media specialist, technical support, technical community management, and then now as an engineer. But my interest talaga is cybersecurity and computer science. So out of this would be my 114th talk, and this will be specifically be my sixth talk when it comes to anything that is related to cloud players, cloud computing. And I believe this is my first time actually going to talk about specifically DevOps. So this is a really interesting topic. But before I start, technically, ayan, wala na kayong takas, guys. Makapag-chat na kayo. Be honest, what are you really expecting to learn today? I know that in the upcoming days, you guys have a lot of talks, events, and definitely they have planned and chosen the topics that the speakers would talk about. So this one, for example, we're focusing on cloud computing and DevOps. I believe not everyone is really interested or gusto maging cloud a developer, cloud engineer, or a DevOps professional. So for you guys, you're taking the time right now, maliban sa required to, what are you expecting to learn today? So this would also give me an idea on how I'm going to navigate. Do you guys already have a deep understanding or a fundamental understanding of what cloud technology is or DevOps? Is it your first time hearing about it? Ayan. And di na kayo nahihiya dito kasi you can comment anonymously. So yung mga organizers ng event, hindi nila malalaman kung sino to. Ayan. So what are you expecting to learn today? And go ahead and use our Q&A. And for those who have access to the webinar chat, feel free. I also have it open. How many? Yeah, we're more than 100. We have 100 students today. So let's see. Ayan, thank you, anonymous sender. We have more on cloud security. Okay. We won't specifically talking about that since we're just focused on the fundamentals. But we can definitely, I believe I did have some recorded talks about it if you want to explore that further. Sabi ni anonymous sender, how to get started cloud and what provider to use. Ayan, it's a really good expectation. Again, we're gonna go to fundamentals, but I do have resources that I can share with you. You can connect with me directly. I do have like I did a talk before about the different providers and what's the best one for you. Ayan, kailangan ko pala mag-scroll. Ang dami. Very good. I'm expecting to learn about the key benefits of cloud computing. Ayan, thank you. What is cloud computing and how does it differ from traditional IT infrastructure? We'll definitely talk about that. Sabi ni BJ, mahirap po ba maging cloud developer? Gusto ko po kasing i-pursue yung ganyan po. Alam mo, BJ, magandang tanong yan. As a sustaining engineer, I do not have a direct responsibilities of a cloud developer, but I do directly work with them. I work with cloud professionals and DevOps. So definitely, I see kung ano yung ginagawa nila a day in the life and I collaborate with them. And wala namang madaring role, but it's definitely challenging. Each role in tech is challenging as long as you're eager to learn and overcome that challenge. Ayan. So definitely, you can definitely, ulit-ulit definitely, you can do that role if you want to. Sabi ni Sean, key technologies used in computing. Sabi ni Kasuma, what platforms do you recommend for data storage? Very, very good expectations and questions. Kinaya na agad tayo. Ayan. But I'm happy that you guys are engaging and hopefully active kayo throughout. Okay? Ayan. Very good. So, let's proceed. So, I appreciate everyone na maliban sa required, they are eager to learn. And definitely, I can see the interest in pursuing a cloud profession in the future. Actually, wala akong nakitang DevOps. But it's okay. Maybe it's a new term na narinig nyo, but this is also a different profession. So we have two sections of our talk today. We have cloud computing and understanding DevOps as well. So I divided it into three subsections. We have define, understand, and internalize. Ayoko matapos yung event na to na pinakinggan nyo lang yung, and yung mga following events na papakinggan nyo lang, dadaan lang sa isip nyo, and wala kayo mapupulot na aral. Whether you're interested or not, I'm gonna make it to a point na you guys see the value of bakit ito yung mga topic na sinishare sa inyo ng mga speakers, bakit nyo kailangan ito matutunan. So definitely, I want you guys to understand it even if you're not gonna pursue it in the future. So we have defined, definitely, aalamin muna natin ano pa talaga yung meaning ng cloud computing at ano naman yung DevOps, ano yung pinagkaiba nito. Once we're able to technically define what both of these are, now we're in the next part to understand. What is the value of it? What is the importance? Ano ba yung mga challenges na na-encounter ng isang cloud professional or DevOps professional? And then, internalize. Itong mga matututunan ko after magdaldal ni Miss Acha, ano ba yung mapupulot ko dito? Nakikita ko ba yung sarili ko na magpa-pursue ng cloud computing field or DevOps field? And how can I apply what I learned today? Because at the end of the day, as tech students, if I'm not mistaken, marami ding graduating dito. After you guys graduate, at university, it's still a continuous learning, and hindi mo mamamalayan na things that people do in different industries like cloud computing and DevOps is also something that you can apply in your personal life, especially that artificial intelligence, automation, and how we promote efficiency and convenience using these tools really is impactful in our daily lives. Ayan. Intro pa lang, ang dami na, di ba? Okay. But nakita na to ng mga organizers eh. Kaya ako tinatanong to kasi baka magutom kayo sa papakita kong slides. So I just want to see if you guys had your breakfast today. Ayan. Do tayo sa Q&A people, sa mga Q&A people. Simple yes or no. Let's see. Tingnan natin. I'm looking forward to 30 responses bago tayo mag-proceed. Ayan. Thank you, Mary Jane. Napaka-honest mo. Not yet. Nako. Ako sa'yo while you're listening here. Ay, di ba? Tulad ni isang anonymous na tele ko makain po habang nakikinig. Very good. Hala. Maaga niyo ata kasi silang pinagising sa webinar na to. Madaming not yet. I just woke up. At least, thank you, nandito ka. Kakagising ko lang. Di pa po. Di pa po. Sad face. Nakain po habang nakikinig. Sabi ni Fritz, yes, ma'am, tinapay at kape habang nanonood. How about you po? Thank you for asking, Aaron. Ano na kasi dito? What na? 6 p.m. na dito. So, I did, thank you for asking. I did had my dinner already. Ayan. Ay, yung isa din. Not yet, sad face. So, gusto ko, i-promise nyo sa akin na kumakain na kayo, kakain na kayo. So, hindi pala to. Hintayin mo munang maluto yan, ha? Baka mamaya. Kakainin mo, hindi pala to. Hello po, kaya sunog. So, the reason why I ask, if nakapag-breakfast tayo, at saan mo kinalaman nito sa cloud computing at DevOps, is when you hear about these terms kasi, ba, cloud computing, cybersecurity, DevOps, parang hala, out of, parang hirap maintindihan itong mga technical terminologies. So that's why we're going to have a lot of analogies today, and we're going to relate cloud computing sa pamamagitan ng pagkain, which is pizza. So my question is, ayan, nasabi ko sa inyo, kumain na muna kayo eh. Breakfast is, I think, the most important meal of the day daw, di ba? Ayan. How do you get your pizza? Ayan. So I need to remind myself na scroll ko. Ayan. So, sa Q&A natin and our webinar chat, ayan. Pag nagkakrave kayo ng pizza, huwag nyo kakain kayo ng pizza breakfast ha. Pero pag nagkakrave kayo ng pizza, ano yung method or process na ginagawa nyo? Do you create your own pizza? Do you order? Do you go to the store? Ayan. Sabi ni Nicole, we buy po. Ayan. Order, sabi ni Anonymous. I'm craving. Sinasabi ko na eh. Ayan. Kaya kumain muna kayo habang nakikinig. Pa-deliver. Very good. Anybody else? Ayan. 100 plus tayo dito, guys. So, gusto ko yung parang pag nagtatanong ako, yung tipong hindi ko na mabasa yung chat, so sobrang active nyo. Ganon. Order po, Food Panda, Grab. Punta po sa Sira's Pizza. Ayan, go to store. Anybody else? Humihingi po sa kaibigan. Ayan, matalino. Sabi ni Fritz, ito, order. Pagdating, inaakay muna. Ayan, napaka-specific. Then, lagay na maraming hot sauce at ketchup. O, diba? Logical thinking, procedural thinking. Ayan. Anybody else? Nako, parang hindi ata active ang mga students sa Our Lady of Fatima University. Let's see. Make my own. Good job. Ayan. Magpabili sa kapatid. Ayan. Anybody else? Do it yourself po. Ayan. Very good, guys. Okay, so looking forward for more active responses here. But the reason why I'm asking is we use cloud computing like pizza. It's easier to understand what cloud computing really is sa pamamagitan ng pizza. Because when we talk about cloud computing, this is how we use our services based on our preference, how efficient we want it to be, and of course, definitely convenience. Diba? Tulad ng pizza, we have our own preferences na we want to make an effort to go to the store. Yung iba wants convenience, deliver it. Same with acquiring services in the cloud space. So this is a concept This is the analogy made by Albert. He used to work at IBM, but he says, cloud computing ay parang pag-order ng pizza, paggawa ng pizza, it's the same. So that's why it says pizza as a service. How you get your pizza is how you weigh responsibility versus control. Gusto mo ba na to take your time, less costly, kung ikaw gagawa, ikaw bibili ng ingredients more, or gusto mong mag-invest? You want to, gusto mong maglabas ng pera, for example, in a cloud service, but ang return on the value or return on investment on your end is you'll just focus on the more complex side of things. So, hindi na nasasayang yung oras mo. So, we're going to think about it. Cloud computing is not a one-size-fits-all. Okay? So, again, pizza as a service, but if you want to have it in a more technical explanation, it's an on-demand availability of computing resources tulad ng storage and infrastructure and as services over the internet. So it eliminates the need for individuals and businesses to self-manage physical resources themselves and only pay for what they use. Diba? It's easier to understand through analogies using cloud computing as pizza as a service. Cute, ayan, okay? That's why di pa tayo tapos. Gonna be more. Actually, wala na masyadong pizza, pero I just want to make sure na kumain muna kayo bago tayo tumuloy dito so information can be retained din. Ayan, very good guys. Okay. So, now we're going to move forward of the different cloud environments or what we call deployment models. So, there's actually the previous talks that I did when it comes to cloud computing that I always share three common ones kasi ito yung mga madalas na nakikita sa mga courses like Coursera, Geeks for Geeks, Microsoft, and other cloud resources or tutorials then. But I did my research today and we actually have four. This was created, I think, in 2021 pa. So it's interesting na ngayon ko lang din ito natutunan and I want to share it with you guys. So we have four cloud environment or deployment models. We have public, private, hybrid, and community. So, public, from the word itself, it's run by third-party cloud service providers. Private, you own it by a single organization or business. We can also have a different, another terminology for private, which is on-premise or on-prem. And third is hybrid, a combination of public and private. And the fourth one is community, which is a multi-tenant hosting. There's multiple businesses or organizations that share the same hosting platform and the share goals using the same hardware. So this is another interesting or fourth type of cloud environment. And so how are we going to make it easier for us to understand the different cloud environments or deployment models is through housing or acquiring a home. Ayan. Right now, guys, do you see yourself, third party providers later. I'm gonna show it to you guys. And I also have, different resources then that, I'll share with the organizers of my previous presentations if you, want a deeper explanation of comparisons, non-providers, cloud services, again, okay. So, the question is, ayan, let's see. Again, gusto ko yung tipong pag sumagot kayo, hindi ko na nababasa, sunod-sunod yung sagot, okay? So, the question is, in the future, after you graduate, do you see yourself renting, owning a home, or building a home? Ayan. Just three simple answers. Do you see yourself renting, owning, or buying a home? Let's see. Ayan na. Dream to daw siya. Tatlo yung options mo. Rent, buy, or rent, buy, rent, own, build. Ayan. Owning a home, owning, oh naman, di ba? Sino, oh yes. Matalino entrepreneur tong asang anonymous at attendee natin. Owning rent, rent to own, build. Gagawa po ng bahay kubo. Bakit hindi, di ba? Kasi pag bahay kubo, kung trip mong lumipat ng lupa, pwede mong dalhin, bayanihan, ganyan. Matalino ka kuya or ate. Owning a home, renting in my first year. Own, sim with a heart. Sabi ni Aaron, own po, value may increase. Owning a home, di ba? Di lang kayo tech professionals, mga business-minded din kayo. I love that. Okay, but well, we're gonna relate it into the service deployment models, rather, is that it's also like when it comes to renting or owning or buying or building, is iba-iba din. Pansin niyo, di ba? Iba-iba yung preference natin. But most of you guys, majority of you, compared sa pizza question natin kanina is, mas magandang may we own the home kasi di ba we have control. So ito yung mga pinagkaiba nila. We have public cloud, like renting, di ba? Like an apartment or a room. You share cloud resources like servers and storage with other organizations. So, ang benefits kasi when you use the public cloud environment, mas madaling i-manage, hindi mo na kailangan intindihin yung mga other maintenance, di ba? Kung wala, pag mag-rent ka ng bahay or apartment, paano kung may nasirang tubo or something like that, you have to pay for repairs, pay for the labor, etc. But since you're renting, people who manage that vicinity or that house or apartment, sila yung bahala na mag-ayos noon. Yun yung pinagandahan naman ng public cloud. And when it comes to the public cloud, like renting, you only pay for what you use. Diba? Hindi nasasayang yung pinanggagastos mo when it comes to renting and utilities, etc. And walang biglang sumusulpot na bills na, oy, ginamit mo to pero hindi naman talaga. So only pay for what you use. And another thing about the benefit of public cloud is performance and reliability. Diba? If you, and especially if you don't want to have that huge of a risk when it comes to the public cloud, even though it says it's public, you can rely on it, especially if nandun na din yung good reputation nila when it comes to the services that you need. On the other hand, nagiging disadvantage din ng public cloud because you won't be able to have much of a control as much as you want to. If you see yourself growing out of using that public cloud environment, it's time for you to shift to a different type of service or different type of deployment model, which is you can shift from public, you can shift to, from public to private, or you can do both, hybrid. So when it comes to security risk, I do see some people are interested in cybersecurity, and when it comes to cloud computing, with the public cloud space, nagiging concern ang privacy and security, of course, kasi some services can be open source and can have some sort of vulnerabilities and hindi natin alam kung naka-cross-contaminate na ba yung mga data na pinaprocess natin or minamanage when it comes to the public cloud. Ayan. Alright, so assess then if you have like a startup or a small organization, you can start with a public cloud kung limited pa yung budget nyo. Pero, and when you scale up, and if you want a more sustainable environment, you can definitely shift to private cloud. So private cloud is naman, you have more control. So it's like owning a condo, di ba? Rent to own, mga ganyan. Actually, rent to own para siyang hybrid na din. And a good thing about having your own space and having having authority to customize it is you have control and you feel more secure, di ba? Pag nag-rent ka kasi, anytime, baka pwede kang paalisin, di ba, ng landlord mo. But when it comes to the private cloud, you feel more secure. Disadvantage lang nito, definitely, it's gonna be more costly. So when we talk about the private cloud in large enterprises or large organizations, it's gonna be costly and a huge investment to set up your own cloud infrastructure. So hardware cost, and making sure that people who are using that services for your organization ay skilled talaga na cloud professional. Ayan. Of course, hybrid cloud, a shared responsibility, it allows the data and application to move between two environments, public and private. And another interesting one is yung number four. This is something that is not usually talked about, which is community. Dito naman, nakikita natin, it's a multi-tenant hosting platform, yun nga, that involves industries and other complementary businesses. Pag sinabing community cloud, they share a same business goal, pero definitely, iba-iba yung kanilang data. So data is still segmented and kept private except in areas where shared access is agreed upon and configured. So this is more beneficial when it comes to cost, ayan, security, and enhanced collaboration. Ang disadvantage lang when you pursue a community cloud environment is kailangan nagkakaintindihan yung mga nag-share na organizations sa mga standards or policies na minamanage nyo within the cloud. People who decide that are yung mga legal team and even stakeholders to enforce those policies. I think definitely included na din yung cybersecurity. Ayan, data in isolation. Mahirap i-maintain. Hindi mo sure na may nakakalusot na pala na data from one organization to another. And since community cloud is not really heard of as much, even though this has been birthed in 2021, so 3 years, it's still rare. This type of model is not used yet, so may mga other resources na available na mas ginagamit ng mga tao, which is hybrid, public, and private. Okay, ayan. Medyo na layo ko na kayo sa pizza. Ngayon naman, dreaming of owning a home, di ba? Okay. However, now that we understand na, ito pala yung meaning ng cloud computing, parang pizza, and then ito naman yung meaning ng mga providers pagdating sa services ng cloud computing, mga deployment models, parang bahay. Now, importante naman, maintindihan natin, especially for those who aspire to be cloud professionals, is we need to understand the problem in this field. This is also something that I learned kasi I'm interested to pursue a cybersecurity career. Sabi nung director of IT namin ba yun, or their vice president of IT sa company that I'm working for, napansin niya, people who want to pursue a career in a certain industry are studying to get those certifications or masyadong focus sila sa technical stuff. But at the end of the day, hindi nila na, they often forget to understand the main problem. Hindi nila nagagamit sa tamang paraan in such a way that you know stuff, but you don't know how to apply it, and you're not sure on saan mo siyang bagay ina-apply. So that's why in cloud computing, now that we know the fundamentals, the type of services, and yung purpose niya, it's important, ano ba yung mga problema na na-experience at nararanasan at nagiging effect ng cloud computing. So you don't need to memorize the numbers here on this slide, but the main problem of cloud computing, lalo na kung if people don't really try to understand the value, is cloud waste. Ayan. So based sa picture na to, guys, again, I'm looking at the question and answer and webinar chat. The problem daw, main problem when it comes to the cloud computing field is cloud waste. Based sa picture na nakikita niyo dito, bakit nagiging problem ang cloud waste? Ayan, see? Why do you think the main problem or the big problem in cloud computing is cloud waste based sa picture na nakikita niyo ngayon? Based din, di ba, natutunan natin yung mga different deployment models, benefits niya, and challenges. But the main and huge problem is cloud waste. Bakit kaya? Sabi ni John, loss of data, price, sabi ni anonymous sender. Ayan, anybody else? Extra cost, dahil maraming data ang hindi nagagamit, stress po. Ayan, sabi ng ating host. Anybody else? Do you also guys agree with the previous answers? Loss of data, stress, ayan. Stress kitang-kita dito kay Kuya, ayan. The right picture, sa left, nagulat siya. Napaluhod ata si Kuya. Di ko alam kung nasa banyo ba siya, nasa office. Kasi di mo alam kung nakaluhod or nakaupo eh. Pero nashock siya eh. Hawak niya yung card niya eh. Extra cost dahil maraming data na hindi ginamit. And those answers are definitely correct. So when we talk about cloud waste, people who acquire cloud services na most organizations and businesses kasi, cloud computing, ito na yung uso ngayon. Instead of managing physical devices and physical servers, it's best for us to transition and use cloud services. But unfortunately, as much as you want to save money and focus on bigger business decisions, nakakalimutan nila na gumamit ng right resources such as cloud professionals to be able to manage and maintain those services. So yun yung nagiging root cause ng cloud waste. Ayan. Sabi ni Daisy, complexity po siguro, kaya masakit ulo niya. Ayan. Kasi niya siguro inaral muna yung fundamentals. Ayan. So, one of the common reasons, if you're going to break it down, ng cloud waste is over-provision resources. Tulad nga nang sabi niya, di ba? Gumagamit sila ng resources na hindi naman talaga nila kailangan. Nasasayang lang yung data, idle or unattached resources, commitment purchase opportunities. Itong purchase, commitment purchase opportunities, minsan may mga providers na magkakaroon na agreement or contract na, oh, ito, 6 months, ito yung package na kagamitin mo for your business through our cloud services. Pero hindi mo, na-realize mo na sa 5 services na in-offer sa'yo, 3, 2 lang pala yung nasusulit mo. Incorrect configuration, lack of automation, and lack of cost management. Sometimes, you can go under budget, but most of the time, it goes beyond your budget to acquire these services na hindi mo napapansin kasi naka-auto pay ka, mag-auto subscribe. But now that we understand the main problem of cloud computing, a good thing about cloud computing is that it promotes flexibility, diba? Efficiency, offers strategic value, it's secure, and it's cost-effective. Just go back to our pizza and house buying, owning, renting strategy. That would be the benefit of cloud computing. But ito na nga. Diba nagutom na kayo yung iba sa inyo kumakain habang nanonood? Definitely, naubos nyo na yung kinakain nyo. So, nagluluto kanina, tingnan mo, baka sunog na yung kinakain mo. Ayan. So, now that we've learned it, ang dami na din natin natutunan. Ano naman sa tingin nyo yung mangyayari kapag nagkaroon ng pizza waste? Ayan, I'm interested to see your answers kasi iba-iba tayo ng waste on how we eat pizza. Do you guys also eat the crust of the pizza? Do you, what do you normally do when you eat pizza? May natitira ba? Do you have waste? And kung merong waste, anong ginagawa nyo sa natirang pizza? Sabi ni Nicole, we eat everything po. No leftover. Definitely, mahal-mahal na pizza ngayon. Tapos, si food panda mo pa, di ba? Siyempre, manghihinayin ka sa delivery charge. Sabi ni Fritz, yes po, simot lahat. Eat with no crumbs, di ba? Ayan, very good. Itatapon. Sad face. Talagang pinahabol niya eh. Itatapon dot. Sabi, bibigay sa alaga. Pwede. Save for later. Papakain sa pet, ilalagay sa ref. Itatago mo sa anika. Tara. Ayan, si Lia nagtuloy. Store sa fridge, if hindi naubos, bigay sa aso. Refrigerate po later. Ayan. How about the others? Wait lang. Before tayo mag-proceed, rin lang tubig sa lit. Do you guys relate with the previous answers? Pag may waste talaga, no? Choice at trash. Sad face. Siyempre naman, di ba pag may natira, pero pag hindi mo na kaya, huwag mo na ipilit. Wala yung hugot, ha? Pizza yung pinag-uusapan natin. Ayan. Very good, guys. Okay. So, definitely, if you want to correlate pizza waste with cloud waste, syempre, if it's something that no longer gives value or something that you do not need, di ba, and would likely go to waste, we dump it or we, yeah, put it in the trash or, kasi hindi mo naman pwedeng, maliban sa logical, siyempre literal pag pizza, pagkain kasi yun, pwede mong ibigay sa pet. But when we talk about cloud services, it's something that we cannot really share kasi it involves our personal and private data, especially mga business processes natin. Ayan, very good guys. Okay, now we're going to proceed with the service models. We're almost at the end of cloud computing, but now we're going to proceed with the three service models of cloud computing. Yan, okay. So we have IaaS, or what we call infrastructure as a service. This is the highest level of control over your IT resources and most closely resembles traditional on-premise IT resources. So what does that mean? So infrastructure as a service is like renting virtual computers and storage space in the cloud. Ayan. Sino dito ang naka-experience na ng computer shop? Dahil ito yung analogy natin. So when we talk about infrastructure as a service, para ka na ding nag-computer shop, you're renting virtual computers. Ayan. IaaS is also something that we can call as infrastructure as a hardware. Ayan, thank you. Very good. May mga nag-hard, may nag-thumbs up. So, relate na relate kayo dito, di ba? It's not evident in 2024 as much, pero di ba back in the day, lalo na kapag nakatira kayo sa mga kanto, di ba, maliliit na lugar, masisikip na lugar, talagang hintayan, sitipan, lalo na pag gusto po mag-extend sa PC5, ganyan. And definitely, nakaka-frustrate as someone who wants to use that resources tulad ng computer. And especially pag, kungari, kailangan mo nang ipasa yung assignment, pero yung isa sa kabila nagdodota, nagpa-extend pa ganyan. So, mahirap pag where you do not have your own resources. Relate to, kung sino man yung tumatawa siya. Ayan. So, but in the business sense, in cloud computing, when we talk about infrastructure as a service, meron kang control over the operating systems, application, and development frameworks. So it's easy kasi you have control over your needs if you want to scale your resources up or down. An example nito ay AWS or Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, Google Compute Engine, and DigitalOcean. Ayan, yun yung infrastructure as a hardware. Now we're going to proceed with platform as a service. Later at the end of this explanation, I have a table which is easier for you guys to digest kung ano ba talaga yung pinagkaiba nila. But this one naman, platform as a service or PaaS, is for developers naman. This service naman focuses on a toolkit for developers like you guys in the future to build and deploy applications without worrying about the infrastructure. Meron na dito mga pre-built tools, libraries, development, environments. For example, if you guys are in the process of your thesis, kung gagawa kayo ng web application, is that you can host your web app through AWS services. Ayan. Yan ang domain host. So, through PaaS, developers focus on building and managing application, while the service provider, tulad ng AWS, just focus on the infrastructure management. Wait lang guys. Yung pusa ko dito nagugutom na din siya, kakatok natin ng pizza tsaka ng ano, wait lang. Ayan, siya naman daw yung kakain. Okay, let's proceed. So, example ng platform as a service is AWS Lambda, Google App Engine, Google Cloud, and IBM Cloud. So, definitely, pwedeng-pwede nyo itong i-practice and i-try kasi meron silang mga free resources na pwede nyo gamitin on a limited capacity nga lang, but you can try this. Okay? And lastly is SaaS, or what we call software as a service. Dito naman ay naka-focus siya applications. These are applications that are ready to use, update, and maintain that is handled by the provider. So you can access this type of service, software service providers through a web browser, and you just have to pay a subscription fee to continually use the service. So software as a service is most likely for people who are not that technical savvy but would want to use cloud services. That's why when we talk about SaaS, it does not require you to have that technical expertise. So an example of this is Salesforce, Google Workspace apps, Microsoft 365, project management tools like Trello. Ayan, ito ngayon, kung na, ano yung ginagamit natin na meeting platform, Zoom, Slack, and Adobe Creative Cloud. But if we want to dive deeper onto the differences, ayan, we have the big three cloud providers, AWS, Microsoft Azure, and Google Cloud. But to expand it further, ito yung breakdown, simplified ng pinagkaiba-iba nila. So ang uses ng IaaS, network architects, experts, and cloud professionals, platform as a service developers, and software as a service end users, most likely those who are not that have that high technical know-how. So technical understanding, IaaS regards technical knowledge, PaaS some knowledge, and SaaS no requirement about technicalities. So, halos same explanations lang din, but skill developer, mid-level, and use among the users of entertainment. Alright, and that ends our presentation for cloud computing. I hope you learned a lot sa pag-usap ng pizza and renting and owning. So now that you learned about the fundamentals of cloud computing, how do you now want to get your pizza? Same answer pa rin ba guys? Gusto niyo pa rin ba mag-order through Foodpanda? Meron dito isa, bilib ako kasi gusto niyang gumawa from scratch. Gusto mo pa rin ba gumawa from scratch? After natutunan natin, ayan, let's see. I'm looking at the chat. Or gusto mo pa rin gumawa ng sarili mong pizza, mag-order. Let's see, ayan. Same. Mag-o-order na lang daw siya. Sabi ni Anonymous, pag gutom or no choice order talaga. Foodpanda pa rin po. No oven, sadly. Get it from a provider. Same pa din, ma'am. Very good. Ayan, definitely. As a customer, as someone who use who utilizes these types of services, we want to experience convenience, and that's also how we can correlate cloud computing services. Very good, guys. Okay. Now we're going to talk about the next topic. But first, the question is, ano ba sa tingin niyo, guys? Now we know paano yung mga process ng getting a pizza, making a pizza, house. Ano mo sa tingin niyo na sa loob ng cookbook? At sa ano ba talaga, cloud professional ba yung papasukan namin pagka-graduate or gusto mo kami maging chef? Kasi bakit puro pagkain? Sabi ni Kazuma, instructions, recipes. Sabi ni DC, recipes, menus, recipes, very good procedures. Definitely very good, guys. So, inside the cookbook is a recipe. And this is naman, when we talk about DevOps, according to DevOps Institute, is something that we can correlate so we can easily understand it. DevOps is like a recipe. It is about combining people, processes, and automation. So this term is coined by Jane Rohl. He's the CEO of the DevOps Institute. And ito yung mostly analogy niya pagdating sa DevOps. So, diba, tulad ng recipe. Ang recipe may mga ingredients yan from major categories tulad ng people, process, and automation. But if you want to become more technical, itong mga sinasabi nating categories ay mga experts that know about lean, agile methodology, site reliability engineering, continuous integration and continuous development, IT, IL, leadership culture, and tools. So it's a collaborative effort, and you have to know not just one, but multiple expertise to be able to be in a DevOps profession. So if you are someone right now as a tech student, as a comms or IT student, na hindi mo pa sure yung specific career path na gusto mo or profession, and you are the type of person na gustong mag-try ng iba't ibang fields in tech, maybe DevOps is something for you na you see yourself as a jack of all trades, but eventually you want to specialize in certain areas of the field. This could also be a good opportunity for you. So, ayan. So, DevOps, parang recipe siya. But if you want to have a more technical definition of DevOps, ayan, a compound development and dev and operation. So DevOps is development and operation. Again, union of people, process, and technology to continually provide value to customers. And cloud professionals, the cloud industry, and the DevOps, they definitely work and collaborate in hand in hand. And if you want to expand it further, these are the different, ito yung mga kinaunang roles. That's why nabuo ang DevOps. Before, when we look at the left side of the screen or the slide, a developer just only focuses on user stories, wireframing, prototyping, essentially main roles of a developer. Yung inputs niya and outputs, software design and implementation. When we go to the upper right side of the slide, ang tester naman, di ba meron tayong mga term sa fundamentals natin as first year to fourth year na UAT, user acceptance testing. It's a separate entity back in the day when inputs we have working software, notes on target behavior, outputs validated software. Kumbaga, talagang nakahiwalay yung mga roles and responsibilities. So, meron tayong operation, nagbabalidate ng software, development notes, working system monitoring, and analytics thereof. Yes, everything maganda din pag when you have these specializations separate. But ang nagiging challenge niya or difficulty is it takes time and it's not really efficient for the workflow to be smooth as much as we want it to be. That's why nagkaroon ng DevOps. Ayan. A good thing about DevOps is accelerating time to market, especially as future developers and engineers, we have a timeline. Na kahit ngayon, 'di ba, pina-practice niya na pag may mga programming activities kayo or exercise, naka-time constraint siya kasi hinahanda na kayo sa real world na you'd be able to meet a certain deadline. Paano mo i-explain sa stakeholder mo or sa CEO na, ay, sorry, hindi ko kayang i-meet tong timeline na to kasi ganun-ganyan. You have to meet the requirement. If it's something that you cannot really comply with, you explain the workaround or yung best practices and methods to be able to meet a certain goal or requirement. Ayan. Next is adapting to the market competition. We have maintaining system stability and reliability and improving the mean time to recovery. But to explain yung life cycle ng DevOps, di ba meron tayong SDLC na tinuturo sa ating systems development life cycle. This is also something that we can apply in a DevOps perspective. Of course, we start by planning. The DevOps team, ang ginagawa nila, ideate, define, and describe yung mga features and capabilities ng application. Detect nila yung progress, ng low and high, ano ba yung priority, ano ba yung feature na dapat nating gawin agad, prioritize. Talagang they're very organized and detail-oriented when it comes to backlogs, tracking bugs, may mga error ba na need natin resolve agad, and they focus on agility and visibility. Active collaboration siya. So next, after na ng planning, development stage, coding, writing, testing, reviewing. So wala na tayong separate tester. All in one na siya. Delivery process of deploying applications. Dito, instead of having dev, tester, and operations to work in their own space, dito nagkakaroon ng active communication and collaboration kasi you gain each other's full trust na mag-complete ang certain tasks. It gives you confidence and of course, peace of mind. Something na napapansin ko kasi whenever people in the industry as an engineer, ang napapansin ko, they lack communication. Aminin man nila sa hindi, minsan, yung mga iba ko nakaka-work na developers or engineers, umaamin sila na pag may bug, iniwasan nila yung bug. Ayaw nilang tingnan yung ticket or yung case kasi mabigat para sa kanila. And kapag nasa DevOps ka, wala kang takas kasi hindi magagawa ng isang tao yung task, hindi sila makapag-progress hanggat a certain issue is not addressed. So that's why it's important na we are active and communicate talaga. Kasi yung mga di, ano guys, ma-feel nyo kapag may problem na or technical issue, di ba, na important, pero yung ka-teammate mo, hindi nagpa-participate. Siyempre, mababawasan ka ng trust, mas gusto mo ikaw na lang gumawa. Pero ang downside nun, it will take you more time, hindi ka nakaka-focus sa mga main task mo. And of course, lastly, operate. This involves maintaining, monitoring, and troubleshooting applications in production environments before you deploy it into a live production or environment. And this requires actionable alerting, full visibility, and underlying system. So once you become a tech professional, you just do not only focus on mga need mong gawin. It's always empathizing with the people that you work with and also definitely active communication and collaborate. Onti na lang guys, malaban na tayo matapos. So that's why DevOps is being appreciated in our generation right now is that it gives us a really good culture to collaborate, to be adaptable, to take accountability. Na kunwari, ay, sorry, na-delay yung progress natin kasi natagalan ako sa ganito. Nakatulala na lang ako sa bug. Hindi ko na ma-resolve. Sorry, guys. Pero ginugol ko, nahanap ko na, back on track na tayo. So, meron tayong short release cycles and of course, continuous learning. So, an example, a real life example of a DevOps case study is public sector. Ayan. The reason why ito yung pinili ko ng case study out of all the different case studies is that most public sectors around the globe and most likely hesitant sila sa change. They're so used and attuned to their old ways na they don't really want to use the technology as a tool, or most of them feel like that they don't want to depend too much on technology kasi it would most likely automate and create its own like organizational or business decisions, which is something that the government wants. They want to take autonomy of or control. So a good example of DevOps in the public sector is the Australian Taxation Office. So they applied the DevOps culture in this field. Ayan, let me just read further details here. So, ang naging experience ng Australian Taxation Office sa pag-apply ng DevOps is that nakatulong ito sa pag-deliver ng new features and updates or online services. Automatic na, na-maintain, na-manage up to date. You don't have to manually intervene or have someone to monitor and maintain that infrastructure. So, lesser time, nag-improve yung stability and security ng kanilang system. So, this was according to King in 2019. Dahil dito, nagkaroon ng valuable example sa public sector na, okay, since dahil ginamit rin na ito ng Australian Taxation Office, yung ibang public sectors, they have interest. Kasi most people, naniniwala lang sila if they see results. And through this result, through this case study, it's very evident that DevOps is a good practice to have and have people who expertise in DevOps are acknowledged and to collaborate with them then. However, diba, now we know one of the challenges ng cloud computing importance. When it comes to DevOps, meron at meron ding challenges yan. So how are you going to encourage people to become, combine the best practices of development and operations, combine them together, create the team, syempre yun, resistance to change, lack of skills, most people are preferred to have specializations, just focus on their main role as a developer, as a tester, and as an operations professional. So yun yung lack of skills and cultural barriers. When it comes to cultural barriers, ito yung DevOps side, not yung literal na cultural na. So people are so used to small teams, hindi pa sila, they're not used to cross-functional teams. They're not used to working with other people outside of their profession. So this is definitely a challenge. If you want to have more detail or visualization, when it comes to cloud computing and DevOps, ito yung more side niya when we apply service models. The blue ones is what a cloud professional manages, and the green ones, ito yung mga cloud service provider. So legacy, on-premise, yung mga physical infrastructure, meron pa tayong containers as a service function. Hindi na natin, we didn't discuss this because it's gonna be more technical now. We take too much of our time, but this is just an example of pizza as a service. And ayan, guys, now that you've learned about cloud computing and development operation, sa mga natutunan nyo at na-realize nyo, whether or not you want to pursue a cloud computing career or a different career path, how will you create your own meal for your future career? And you are your own chef of your future tech careers as tech student. So, basta mga natutunan nyo, ano yung mga naging takeaway nyo on how you're going to create your meal for your future career? Maliban sa nag-create kayo ng pizza, ayan. Let's see. Do you see yourself, nagkaroon ba kayo ng interest na, baka para sa akin ang cloud computing or DevOps? Let's see some answers. Ayan, let's wait. While we're waiting for the answer, ang dami kong dinadal sa inyo, guys. But the really most important thing that I want you to have like a takeaway in our session for today is that the importance of cloud computing and DevOps teaches us na to encourage ourselves, regardless in a perspective of a tech professional, but this is also something that we can apply in our personal lives. It encourages ourselves and the people around us to adapt to change, especially that technology is a continuous learning. Pag naging professional na kayo and you work in the industry, dun mo marirealize na ang dami mo kailangan aralin. The more you learn, the less that you actually know. That's why it's really important to be up to date with these technologies, kasi these are tools that we use. So it's important to be open to that, to adapt to change, and practice collaboration. Kung nahihirapan ka, huwag kang mahiyang magtanong. People are willing to help you as long as you ask. And at the end of the day, there's no such thing as stupid answers, kasi araw-araw, we learn. Ayan. So, I hope you guys learned a lot today. Let me know kung ano pa yung topics na gusto nyong matutunan. If you still want me to talk about cloud computing, let me know. Ayan, wait lang guys. Medyo mahaba yung nakabuong screen yung Q&A natin eh. Pero, I'll drop the link here in the webinar chat. I don't know if you guys can see it, but let me know if you can click it. I'll just also give it to the organizer. So go ahead. Or you can scan this QR code. Ang nga pala, may QR code nga pala nilagay. Let me know what you want to learn about next. Let me know yung feedback sa talk natin, if it's more easier for you to understand technical concepts through analogy. Let me know. I look forward to your responses soon. And if you have any further questions outside of our session today, you can definitely reach out to me through my social media accounts. Ayan, you can build your LinkedIn profile. If you want to become a cloud professional, connect with cloud professionals on LinkedIn. I really highly recommend, if wala pa kayong LinkedIn, gawa na kayo. You can also reach me on my Facebook page at Shaabem, also on Messenger, YouTube, Instagram, and X. And guys, thank you so much for your time, and I hope you learned a lot today. And let me know if you have any questions.
Ayan, thank you so much, Ms. Athena, for the informative presentation on cloud computing and DevOps. From discussions about pizza, home ownership, and computer shops, everything contributed to a deeper understanding of our topic on cloud computing and DevOps.